Okay, so it's Splinter's Tracks, day 9. But first, before we go on with today, let me kind of bring you up to speed on what's been happening with Splinter. Okay, so as you know from his last tracking day, we found him in the woods a few hundred feet from a large hollow tree. And then yesterday we found Splinter in this cabin that's directly behind me. So take a look at this footage from yesterday and just see where we found him. Okay, so we think our big black rat snake might be in that small cabin. Not sure yet, but I'm getting a very strong signal. The one we're tracking?
That cabin.
Yeah. Splinter the rat snake may be in that cabin or on the other side in the forest. We're about to find out.
Isn't that dog called Balo?
Yeah, that's Balo.
Balo. I remember Balo.
Yeah, he's not under the office. He's this way. Seems that way. Really strong signal.
Under it.
I don't know. Yeah, he may be under it. He may be in the attic. But it sure is loud in this area, isn't it?
Ground score!
Okay, let's go around it.
I think I know where he might have gone.
Okay, the signal's gone.
Down there. Point it down there.
I think you're right. I think he is in the cabin. Who knows where he is?
In the cabin, though?
Oh, look how many holes there are. There are so many holes, and that's a good question. But this cabin is just riddled with holes.
Is it used? I don't think it's used anymore.
They don't use it.
So are we allowed to go in?
See the hole right there?
Yeah, he could have gone in through that hole. But he's probably just sitting somewhere. I'm going to go in and take a look.
Yeah, come on.
I'll let you know. I think I'll go up the steps.
Let's leave this stuff alone, guys.
Thank you. Now, I don't know if it's even unlocked. Oh, it's searing hot in here. Now, you guys stay outside. I'm just going to look around. Oh man, it's hot in here. Must be about 120 degrees. He's not going to be in here. I bet he's in the attic. Let's see. I don't think he would be over here laying behind the gasoline. No, but there's a hole, a snake-sized hole in this corner he could have easily come through. Did you say you're Queequeg? Oh, I didn't know your name was Queequeg. That's cool. All right, here we go. I'm going to look underneath the building because we keep hearing a thumping sound. Could be the dog, Searsha. May also be a critter. I don't see anything under there. But there's so much insulation knocked down. There's no way to tell. Okay, now let's go back inside. Okay, so I've come back into the cabin, and I used my radio to try to pinpoint where Splinter the rat snake is, and I found him. He's right in this area. He is directly on the other side of the ceiling boards. And if you look, you can see through that crack some shells from rodent activity. So that tells me that he's probably gone up into the attic and eaten several rodents, and now he's just sitting up there digesting. All right, we can't see him, but we know where he is. Very cool. And I almost forgot to mention that the temperature in the attic is around 98 degrees. I used a probe thermometer to stick it between the boards, not right where the snake is, but about a foot or two away, and it's close to 100 degrees, so it's really hot up there. It's about 85 in here. Here's how he may have gotten in. Perfect snake size hole. Or he just came up the inside of the wall, or the outside of the wall, I'm sorry, and went up in the eaves. It's really easy to get in, I'll show you. Okay, let's go outside. Okay, so he could have entered there. You see the squirrel hole? There's a squirrel hole up here, guys. Right there. He could have gone in and eaten a big belly full of gray squirrel, but he's directly inside there behind those boards, sitting in the attic, probably on top of the insulation. And he probably crawled right up the outside of the building here, because this would be nothing for a rat snake. Using these little edges, he could have easily crawled right up and went right in that hole. Okay, that was pretty cool, right? All right, so today I decided to come out and see if Splinter was still in the cabin or if he had moved. So let's see if we can find where Master Splinter is today. So yesterday he was directly up behind the eaves in the attic of this cabin. Take a look. Right up there, above the window, in the attic. And it was close to 90 degrees in the attic, which is really crazy. And it's still quite warm inside the cabin. So you can see why a large rat snake might want to spend time in a building like this. For one, it's warm. And of course, two, this building is full of mice. And there's lots of entryways. Well, it also has termites. Check it out. Yikes. But lots of entryways, such as this hole. And of course, being a rat snake, Splinter could easily just climb right up the outside of this building and go in any number of small holes in the wood. There's a really big one we saw yesterday. Up there in that corner under the eave, a hole that squirrels chewed. So he could have gone in that way as well. All right, let's find him. Let's go inside. Okay, yesterday when we tracked him to this spot, he was directly on the other side of the ceiling boards right here. Today, he may still be there. Feels like a dry sauna in this building. Man, I'm starting to sweat. Aha. I'm getting a really faint pulse down here underneath these gas cans, so I wonder if he's under the floor, right in that area. Let's try again. That corner, under the floor, I believe. Let's go back out and check. All right. He's somewhere in the crawl space. But I'm not crawling in there to look for him. He's still in the cabin, but he's moved from up in the attic down through the wall into the crawl space. Now, I don't know if that means he got hot and just needed to cool off, in other words, thermoregulate, or is he getting ready to exit the cabin?